Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to boost the sound in Windows 11 to make all sounds louder. The method in this video should work for all sound output devices, including headphones, headsets, and speakers. We will start with the main method to boost the sound volume, and then after, if that didn't work, I have a few quick methods to try as well. You can use a combination of the methods to boost your sound, and it may even improve your sound quality too. We do need to download some software for the main method, but the setup is fairly simple, and I'll guide you through the full process step by step. Before we get into the methods, please be careful when increasing the volume, as I'm not responsible for any broken devices or hearing problems. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. The main method is to download and install a piece of software called Equalizer APO. I've used it plenty of times in the past to boost volume, and it can work on any sound device. The link to the site will be in the description. When the page loads, it should look something like this. As you can see, this software gets thousands of downloads every week. Click on the green download button here where my mouse is to start the download. The download should start automatically in 5 seconds. If the download doesn't start automatically, click on the grey problems downloading button here. Then click on the blue direct link button. It should download now. If you are using a 32-bit operating system, you will need to download that version from another place. Click on the Downloads tab here and then select the 32-bit version. That should then start automatically downloading, but once again, if it doesn't, use the direct link. Once the download has completed for any version, open the installer and then select Yes on the User Account control screen. You may need admin privileges for this. When the installer opens, click Next, then I agree, and then choose a destination folder for the software. The default destination should be fine, but just remember where it is, as we'll need to go to it later. Click Next, and then Install. Once the installation is complete, you will be prompted with a window that asks you to choose a device. You need to choose the device you wish to boost the sound for. It could be called speakers, Realtek High Definition Audio, or the name of your device. If you don't see your device, you could try connecting it using another port on your PC. If you are unsure which is your device, select more than one or even all of them just to be sure. You can select the devices by checking the boxes next to them. With your chosen devices selected, click OK to move on to the next section. You will now need to restart your PC. You can do this now or later. Return to the video once you have done that, and then we'll be able to continue with the method. So hopefully you have restarted your PC and you are back now for the next part of the tutorial. Firstly, we need to find where we saved the software. The file should be called Equalizer APO, and if you chose the default location, this will likely be the Program Files folder, which is located within your main drive. Open it, and then open the application called Editor. If it says that Equalizer APO has not been installed to the selected device, click Yes and try another output device like earlier. Once you are in the software, it will have the devices that it is installed to at the top. Choose your device from this list. If once again you aren't sure which your device is, you might want to change the settings for all of the devices separately. Also, if for some reason you lose surround sound with this software, you might be able to turn it back on with the drop-down box in the top right. In the editor, there should be a preamplification section at the top. If there isn't, click on the green plus icon, then basic filters, then preamp. Before you change the preamp, I would be careful when increasing the value, as some devices may not allow for more volume, and I am not responsible for any hearing loss or broken headphones or other devices, so please be careful when increasing it. You can manually adjust the gain with the arrows, and if the instant mode box is checked, you should be able to hear a slight increase or decrease in the volume. It is also worth clicking on File and then Save if you don't notice any difference. Also bear in mind that if you didn't restart, the software will not work yet. Some headphones and devices may not change much, and some not at all, and this is likely to mean your device isn't designed to go any louder. If this is the case, you could try using your device with another connection or port. Before you exit the software, make sure you've clicked on File and Save. Finally, if you ever want to uninstall the software, you can do so by running the uninstall application, which is within the main Equalizer APO folder. Whether or not the last method worked, we'll now move on to some other quick methods to boost the sound in Windows 11. First, we are going to make sure that the volume is set correctly. There's a slim chance that certain apps or programs are set to a volume lower than your main system volume. To check this, first go to the main settings page by searching for it. In the settings, click on System from the options on the left side, although you should be in here by default. In the system settings, click on Sound and then scroll down and look for the option called Volume Mixer in the Advanced section. In the Volume Mixer, look under the Apps section and make sure that all of the apps are set to 100%. Otherwise, they may be quieter than the other sounds. You will probably need to open your chosen app before doing this to make it appear on the list. It might also be worth checking to see if there are any problems with the sound on your PC. To do this, go back to the main settings page by searching for it, and then in the settings, click on System from the options on the left side, but again you should be in here by default. In the system settings, click on Troubleshoot, and then on the next page, choose Other Troubleshooters. Now click on Run next to the Playing Audio Troubleshooter and choose the device you want to use and allow Windows to look for any possible problems. The next method to try is to head back to the sound settings and then in the output section, look for your sound output device and click on it once. In here, make sure that both the left and right channels match up, and then it might be worth trying to see if turning on some of the features helps make the sound louder. There might be an option called Spatial Sound or Enhance Audio. Turn these on and test the sound to see if there is any difference. Up next, we can try turning on Bass Boost in Windows 11. To do this, we need to go to the Control Panel. You can get there by searching for it in the search bar. In the Control Panel, go to Hardware and Sound, and then click on the green sound link on the next page. A new window should open. In this window, first make sure you are in the Playback tab. Now look down the list for your device. If you don't see it, make sure you are able to show disconnected and disabled devices and then enable it. Once you've found your device from the list, double click on it or click on it once and then choose Properties. In the Properties window, go to the Enhancements tab. In the Enhancements tab, you should see the option for a bass boost and you can check the box to the left of it to turn it on. With it selected, click once on the settings button and then try increasing the decibel level and potentially even the frequency to make other parts of the sound louder. Remember to click on OK or Apply to save these changes. If you don't have the Enhancements tab or don't have the Bass Boost option, then it might be worth trying to update your device drivers. You can also try updating the Realtek High Definition Audio drivers. If you're not sure how to do that, then click the card on screen now to watch my video showing you how. You can also try getting a Browser Volume Booster extension. Go to the Browser Add-in Store, for example the Chrome Web Store, and search for a Volume Booster. Use the reviews to see if they are any good, and that should allow you to boost all of the sounds within your browser. And so that is how to make all sounds louder or boost the sound on a Windows 11 PC or laptop. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your Windows PC. Help support the channel by visiting the store, the link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below. And if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.